this is Canadian Men's Championship. It's the second biggest sporting event in Canada, other than the Grey Cup. I got involved in making ice 30 years ago. I came from Switzerland, immigrated from Switzerland about 36 years ago, and I came to Gimli, Manitoba, and I worked on a grain farm, and during the winter there wasn't a lot to do other than hauling some grain every now and then, and I started making ice with this old gentleman at the old Gimli Curling Club, and then just volunteered all over the world for, Briars and the World Championships and for many, many years, and then just worked my way up and kind of got into the business, and that's kind of how it went.
How I met Hans was in high school. School announcements in the morning, I guess his team was looking for a couple of players on their team for the Men's Curling League, and I called the number that, and it turned out to be him, so that's how I ended up meeting him, curling with him, and I worked with him quite a few times. Couple dozen times, I'm sure, over the last 10 years. Yeah, a really good gentleman. I've learned a lot from him. And very precise in what he does, which is very good to have or do in an event like this. So he's very, very respected for that and getting everything done just perfect. So
the sport of curling is very well known here, right? So it's quite easy to get volunteers for people to help. Like you see here, there's a lot of people helping. If you go to different places, like you do most of the work yourself.
I came down in 2006 for the Scott Tournament of Hearts, and I found out that it was in London again, and I wanted to be a part of it again because I had a great time working with the crew then, and look forward to having another good time with the crew here again.
You come here to volunteer, you're going to stay for the 2 weeks. Like I'm probably not even going to go home.
I love the game. I switched from hockey to curling. Partly because my mom didn't want me to play hockey anymore, and then just fell in love with the game, and I thought there'd be no better opportunity than maybe get to see the inside of a major event than to try and volunteer, and I applied, and I was very fortunate to be selected.
Here to gain some experience, work with, as much as they say they're not world-renowned ice makers, I think they are, and get some experience with some of the best in the world.
I'm always interested in ice when I play on it and learning from every iceman I talk to. So I know that I'll learn and something working here. I've already learned today.
I haven't had a chance to volunteer for a Canadian event before. I have done a provincial event before, and it's a lot of fun. And, it's not very often that you're going to have something like this come to London, so I really wanted to be a part of it.
I've never volunteered before, so I thought I owed the sport something.
Well, I've curled since the mid-90s, and I volunteered at the Scots and wanted to volunteer at this one.
I basically wanted to understand how a briar worked. I've watched a lot of it on television, but as you know, there's a lot goes on behind the scene.
We actually have a pretty strict guideline now. The World Curling Federation gives us a guideline. We have to sign a contract with them. We don't have to do it with Canadian Curling Association, but the World Curling Federation. We have to have between 4 and maximum 5 feet of curl, and the ice has to be between 24 and 25 seconds of speed, and we have to be in that guideline. Doesn't matter if you're the best in the world, if you don't have things going for you, if the weather doesn't cooperate, or if you don't have the facility, like say this facility, it doesn't have humidification. Like this time of year, it's supposed to be raining like for several days, Friday. Like I can't do nothing about that. Like if it's going to get frosty, it'll be my fault, but there's absolutely nothing I can do about it. If you don't have thick skin in this job, you can't do it. And you have to know very clearly in your mind that you are doing a good job.